Can I get a witness in here?
So I wouldn't let go.
Wow, it's a privilege, it's an honor for me to be in your various lives. My name is Olufunke Adetuberu. This is Take Your Life Back on this wonderful, amazing station. It's a privilege to be able to reach out to you and speak the word of life, the word of grace, to give you your inheritance amongst them that are sanctified. Your life is the only one you have. As a matter of fact, life is essentially a personal adventure. No matter what it is, it's your life. And whatever has happened to you, whether you're in a wheelchair, emotionally, mentally, physically, psychologically, maybe you were dropped like Mephibosheth in Lodebar. You were dropped in a dry place where there is no pastor. You can put yourself together, get yourself back, get out of the wheelchair, listening to the beckoning of the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. And you can tell yourself, like the prodigal son said, I'm going home. Whatever happens, let me go home. The worst that can happen is for them not to accept me, for them not to receive me, but I'll go home. And listen to me, one thing that stops people from taking their lives back is shame. The only thing that is not redeemable is death. Shame is redeemable. We have not been called to shame. We have been called to fame. Jesus never called us to shame us. He bore our grief. He carried away our sorrows. The chastisement of our peace was upon him. By his stripes we were healed. At the cross, the works of shame was sorted out. He's a man of sorrow, acquainted with grief. He experienced shame on the cross for what he did not do, for the sin he did not commit. So no matter where you are, no matter your struggle, no matter the level of your decadence, in the area of your struggles, maybe you are somebody that is a rageaholic. You get angry like, you know, as if there's a volcano on the inside of you. Yes, you can take your life back. Maybe you are the one that is drenched in sleeping around. You are a married man. Anything is scared goes. You always have to look for another woman, you know. And, you know, it's been a battle. You can take your life back. Maybe you don't even know how to be prudent. You've not been able to put your finances together. You've worked and worked, but nothing is coming forth. You can't put yourself together. Your finances is not in order. You are not balanced. You can take your life back. Probably, you are listening to me now, and the problem you are having with yourself is that you just masturbate to stupor. You can't help yourself. You've done everything. You have fasted. You have prayed. You can still take your life back. I can be resolute with that. Maybe you are just addicted to pornography. You watch pornography. You stay there on and on and on. As a matter of fact, it's as good as your brain is all engulfed in pornography. You can still take your life back. There's no level that you find yourself that you cannot take your life back. Listen to me this moment. As you make a decision, we are moving into the new year. As you make a decision to step on a journey of recovery, you will recover. You will overtake. You will recover all. Your life will be beautiful. The fragrance, the perfume of your life, people will smell it. The odor will go everywhere. You know something that shocked me about the prodigal son? He made up his mind that he was not going to be ashamed. Shame is redeemable. He said, I'm going to put shame aside. Don't forget, there's so many circumstances that surround him. Maybe you have been caught in the very act. Maybe your wife caught you committing adultery. Maybe your husband caught you committing adultery. The moment you have insight, you are able to take the journey of recovery, take the route of a changed life, walk on the journey of, I'm going to work on myself, I'm going to do everything, I'm going to pay the price, I'm paying the price of recovery. Welcome on board. Rapture is your limit. You're going to be shocked how you're going to recover, and people all around will look at you and you become a wonder that cannot be wounded. That is the beauty of recovery. You know, when the prodigal son said he was going home, he left. A lot of people are looking at him. Let me give you the picture of what happened to the prodigal son. You know what? When that guy said he was going and he was going to take everything, everybody heard. It was the news all over the place. I said it in one of the episodes. They must have brought out the cars and, you know, just putting on the siren, and everybody knew because he was going on a prodigal journey. He made it loud. He allowed people to know that he was really going on a riotous life, a careless life, a life of shame and reproach. But when he was coming back, he needed to take the same route. But something supernatural happened because he made up his mind that he was going home. And of course, you don't receive a visitor in Israel without knowing the visitor coming, without the head of the home to go and welcome the visitor. Guess what? The moment the father heard that he was coming home, the father looked at himself and said, wow, this boy had shame, but I'm going to walk the shame with him. I'm going to let the people know that when you come back and you are ready to take your life back, you are ready to go all the way to the place of honor, dignity, and glory. Guess what? The father went to the entrance of the city, walked the shame with his son. Wow. You know what I was looking at? You know, some people would have been there. I would stone him, a prodigal son, bad boy, alcoholic, drunkard, a smoker, a humanizer, whatever. You know, they were going to be giving him by according to the measure of which he went away with. But guess what? The moment they saw the father with him, they said, hey, so what else do you want to say? Who else is going to harass him? His father was with him. His father is walking the shame with him. He just silenced every opposition. Listen to me. When you take your life back, you're going to silence every opposition. You're going to silence everyone that has looked down on you. You're going to tell everybody, shut up. I'm walking with my father. He's a restorer. He will restore the years that the locus of sexual addiction, the locus of perversion, the locus of promiscuity, the locus of infidelity, he will restore it back to you, give you a life. If you are ready to take your life back, please welcome on board. It's possible. I've showed you scriptures. The father now not only welcomed him gloriously with a party, he finally threw a party. Kill cows, the best of all the cows. That tells you something. You better tell the devil to shut up because you are on a journey of recovery. You're on a journey to take your life back. Tell the devil to shut up. Just come home. Thank you for listening. I'll be right back.
This same man you are complaining about pays your school fees.
Oh, Mom!
Shut up! You must not tell anyone about this, okay?
Shh, shh. If you attempt to leave, I will kill you.
Don't do this, I beg of you, please.
Do you know domestic violence takes many forms, including physical, sexual, emotional, and mental?
G Matters Devotional is an everyday devotional which sets to inspire, uplift, teach, and motivate girls, young ladies, and women from the age of 13 and above
on life issues as regards to emotions, love, mental wellness, and stability.
From the host of She Matters, Reverend Olufunke Adetuberu.
You can now get a copy of your She Matters Devotional
at Fresh 105.9 FM, Lagos Ibadan Bypass, Challenge Ibadan.
The Faith and Miracle International Church, 2 Lebanon Club Road, Iyagoku Aleshinoye Junction, Ibadan.
Also at the University of Ibadan Bookshop and All Food Co. outlets.
For more inquiries, you can call 0802-324-2389.
She Matters Devotional, the must for all female.
I almost gave up. I was right at the edge of a breakthrough, but couldn't see it. The devil really had me, but Jesus came and grabbed me, and threw me to help me grow, so I wouldn't let go.
God's mercy kept me.
God's mercy.
Can I get a witness in here that knows about God's grace?
Welcome back to this wonderful program on PRZ FM in England. It's a privilege once again to be in your various lives. If you're having a struggle, you want to communicate with me, you can send me an email on cryonmenow@gmail.com. You can follow me on my Twitter handle, which is Adetuberu Abimbola, or my Instagram handle, Funke Adetuberu. My Facebook page is Shimata's Olufunke or Olufunke Adetuberu. Anyhow, please communicate. Nobody recovers in isolation. When it comes to recovery journey, we work it together. You know, I was talking about the father of the prodigal son. He was coming home. It was a journey of recovery, but he didn't do it in isolation. You cannot live alone. If you live alone, you die alone. The Bible says that it is not good for a man to be alone. It's not only talking about marriage. It's talking about relationship that is an addition. If you refuse to relate with people that will add to you, automatically they will subtract from you. Life is about relationship. Your journey of recovery cannot be done in isolation. So send me a text message. I have my numbers here. +234-090-358-14-892 or +234-90-20-10-80. All of these numbers, either way, we can communicate and we can get through to one another. I'm still passionate about this journey of recovery. You can take your life back by not being bothered about shame. The father of the prodigal son took a party. Now listen to me. One of the things that messes people up in the journey of their recovery is the people around them. What would they say? How would they feel? Excuse me. Let them say. Whatever anybody wants to say, let them say. When your life is better, when you become a celebrity, when you become an envy of your mates and your friends, they will begin to change their minds. People change their minds easily. You know, failure is an offer. Success has many generations. When people succeed, people will try and lobby around the person. I used to know her. She's my friend. She's my uncle. She's my sister. That's how it works. So I want to encourage you. Don't get bothered. You know, something happened in the same family of that man, the prodigal son. When his daddy threw a party, there was a reaction. Can you just not bother yourself about reaction? If you keep listening to the voice of your position, you lose your position. Don't get yourself bothered at all about anybody that is going to say anything. What is important is the power of focus. What is important is that you're on the journey of recovery. How do I mean? When you are ready to go all the way, listen to me, it's not easy to recover, especially when you are drenched and you are soaked in some of this act and attitude. If you find yourself being too involved in pornography, in masturbation, in acting out, in promiscuity, whatever anger, whatever it is that you have been addicted to, what is addiction? Addiction is a man forming a habit, and that habit has now formed the man. That act of yours, that those things you do, the vices, has become the second nature. It has become part of you. Then you need to do it with someone. Don't be bothered about what people will say. What is important? I'm repeating that on purpose. What is important is that you've taken your life back. You are living a life of purpose. You are excited about life. Look at what this brother of the prodigal son did. He began to get angry. Can you imagine? That is another point. If you don't mind me saying this, it is not everybody that is happy that you're happy. Some people are happy that your life is not good. Some people are happy that you are sleeping around. Some people are happy that you have 4 children for 4 different men. Some people are happy that your home is not good. Some people are happy that you are struggling, that your husband is beating you, your wife is beating you, or you are beating your wife. Either way, some people are so happy about it. So don't let anybody mess your mind up in the area of the journey of recovery. Please take your life back. Tell yourself, I'm going home. I'm sure the prodigal son's brother had an attitude, and they are all over the place. People that have attitude, they are not happy for you. They want you to die in sin. They want you to keep sinking in your sin. They want you to remain on the spot. Don't mind them. Can I say this? If you don't want anybody to say anything about you, say nothing, do nothing, become nothing. They will still talk. You are a waster of resources. What is wrong with you? You don't even have sense. They will still abuse you. So you better go ahead on the journey of recovery. When this man got home, he wasn't going home to become a celebrity. He was not going home for anybody to party with him. He wasn't going home to become anything. He was just going home with humility. Can you just walk yourself back to the journey of recovery with humility of heart? Let your heart be broken. David said, create in me a new heart, O God. Renew a right spirit within me. Cast me not away from your presence, O God. Take not your Holy Spirit from me. He said, restore unto me the joy of your salvation. And God finally did something. God said, a broken and a contrite heart, God will not despise. When you come to God, in the place of your pain where you come to God with the understanding of where you've been and where you are now and the future you have. I'm telling you, when you take your life back, you become a voice to be reckoned with. Because listen to me, we are living in a days that people really are not comfortable with your theory anymore. They want to be sure God has forgiven you, you sure you have found mercy, you sure you're no more drinking, you're no more smoking, you're no more doing those vices. Wow, I want to know this God. That is the secret. Your mess becomes your message. Your mess becomes your mandate. Your mess becomes your ministry. You become a voice in that area, and that is where I'm going. Please take your life back. I may not be able to choose the way I was born, but I can choose the way I will die. Don't allow shame. I'm deliberately emphasizing shame today. Shame has made some people to keep their secrets, to keep the lead of their secrets. They will not tell anybody. They will not let people know so that they will not see me bad. Let them see me bad. Let God see me good. Let them see me as evil. Let God see me as good. That's the secret. When people are ashamed, they don't open up their secret and listen to me. I don't know if I've said it in this episode. I discovered there was a time in my life I had wound on my toe knees. I think I have to repeat that story. You know, the toenails was really hurting me. And the person that was treating my knees, he said, no, mommy, can you just treat this nail? Let's remove the nail and treat it. I said, no, just clean it. Clean underneath. Cover it like that. Let it be like that. Don't worry. I'll polish it and I'll go. But I was in pain. I will put a lot of medications, you know, under the nails. Which is the best option? Remove the nails. Let it grow naturally. Heal naturally. And I'll be fine. But I refuse. If you refuse to change, you'll be chained. If you refuse to recover, you cannot discover your destiny. Guess what? One day I was preaching on the podium and my nails fell off and blood was everywhere. I preached for 2 weeks without shoes. I was limping. I had to go to the hospital. And the Holy Spirit said to me, whatever you cover will decay. That is the pain of covering what you are supposed to expose. Thank you for listening to me. I'll be right back.
This same man you are complaining about pays your school fees.
Oh, Mom!
Shut up! You must not tell anyone about this, okay?
Shh! If you attempt to leave, I will kill you!
Don't do this, I beg of you, please!
Do you know domestic violence takes many forms, including physical, sexual, emotional, and mental?
Chim Matters Devotional is an everyday devotional which sets to inspire, uplift, teach, and motivate girls, young ladies, and women from the age of 13 and above
on life issues as regards to emotions, love, mental wellness, and stability.
From the host of She Matters, Reverend Olufunke Adetuberu.
You can now get a copy of your She Matters devotional
at Fresh 105.9 FM, Lagos Ibadan Bypass, Challenge Ibadan.
The Faith and Miracle International Church, 2 Lebanon Club Road, Iyagoku Aleshinoye Junction, Ibadan.
Also at the University of Ibadan Bookshop and All Food Co. outlets.
For more inquiries, you can call 0802-324-2389.
She Matters Devotional, the must for all female.
So I'm here today!
I want to say a very big thank you to all our listeners. Thank you so much for listening to this program. It's such an amazing time we are having together. Please don't hesitate to book an order for your devotional. It's going to change your life. It has to do with relationship stability, understanding the dynamics of, you know, getting the right person, making the right choices, understanding sexuality. Girls, if you're a woman, please, I'm not trying to tell you to take something that will not benefit you. You will thank me for this time and eternity for choosing to order for the devotional. Once again, my name is Olufunke Adetuberu. You still have to take your life back. Life is too short to take it for granted. Anything you don't value, you lose. Look at my toenails. I told you I had to preach for 2 weeks without wearing shoes, and I was in pain because I was trying to cover it. Please don't cover your shame. Don't cover what is going on in your life. Don't cover that secret struggle. Cry out. And let me be honest with you, you don't cry before someone that will not say sorry to you. Some people have cried to wrong places, they've cried to wrong people, and today they have become the subject of mockery. Well, no problems, it's one of those things. But please cry to the right quarters. Tell the right person. Tell people that will sympathize and empathize with you and help you to walk the shame and deal with your struggle and deal with your addiction. You can be free totally. This boy went on a riotous living. He was a drunkard. He was a humanizer. He was going to prostitute. He was going everywhere to seek pleasure. And finally, he had pressure. And pressure pushed him back to his creator. Pressure is not a problem. When pressure rises, you rise with the pressure. You become a treasure when you respond positively to your pressure. If you don't respond positively to your pressure, you won't become a treasure. You become a trash. You become someone that people will be talking about. You become a negative reference point. They will, in your family, they say, look at your uncle. Look at that, your brother. Look at that, your cousin. Look at that, your sister. He drinks. She smokes. He does this. She does that. But if you quickly recover, you'll be so shocked that they'll be saying good things about you. Ah, that woman, once he was blind, now he can see. That is the beauty of taking your life back. That is the beauty of not minding the shame. Do you know the brother of the prodigal son? Don't forget, they are everywhere. They are your place of work. They are your church. They are even more in churches than where you work. Because that place, there is so much holier than thou attitude, so much a way of, you know, trying to tell somebody that the person is not, does not fit to even enjoy the goodness of God. If you find yourself in that kind of position and the kind of crowd, please be focused. Take your life back. What is important to you is to make sure that you don't cover anything. What is more important to you is to get your life in order and in perspective. If they can't beat you, they will join you. And you know the beautiful thing, the father of the prodigal son had to rebuke the brother of the prodigal son. You know why? People don't know the heart of God. Listen to me, God wants you to recover. It is the joy of God. That was why the father of the prodigal son made a statement. He said, there is a joy in heaven over one sinner that repents. When you take your life back, when you despise the shame, you come to a place of repentance, the place of honor, coming back to honor God. You'll be dazed, the kind of joy that comes in heaven over that your decision. If you are making a decision with me today to give your life to Christ, it's so easy. I did it 33 years ago. I opened the door of my heart. I told him to come in. And before I knew it, I had peace. I had peace. And that peace is the key. It's a sign that you have met with your creator and you are reconciled with him. No matter how good you are, if your child poo in his body, you will clean the mess before you carry the child. The mess of sin is clean by the blood of Jesus. Can you just pray this prayer after me? Lord Jesus, I'm sorry for the life I've been living. Today, I repent of all my sins. I want to take my life back. I ask of you that you will forgive me. Whatever I've done, please have mercy on me. I want to start with you. If you are genuinely pray that prayer, please don't hesitate. Send me an email. Send me a text message. Make sure you communicate with me so that we can take your life further and further to another level. When a baby is born, the baby had to be bathed, the baby had to be breastfed, or else the baby will die. That decision is like giving back to you spiritually. You need to grow. You need to develop. You need to start working on yourself. You need to go through a recovery class. That's what I do. That's the things I do to help people to break from their sexual struggle. If you are struggling with your emotions, you have anger, you have sexual problem in any way, and you say, okay, I've given my life to Christ, I'm fine. No. Jesus said, if an unclean spirit goes out of a man, he walks through dry places, seeking rest and findeth not. He said, I will go back to that house. If he goes back to your life and he finds your life clean, swept and garnished, it's going to be worse. You are listening to me. Some of you are Christians. You know you are born again. But when you go out to watch pornography, it's like you have never met with Jesus. Or you keep acting out, masturbating. You keep acting out, committing adultery. You keep acting out, doing things that you know it's absurd. I'm sure you know that you are feeling guilty and you have told yourself severally, but I'm born again. I'm a child of God. This is the time to take your life back. Please don't hesitate to send me an email on the numbers that I'm going to be calling now. You can send me an email on cryonmenow@yahoo.com, and you can follow me on my Twitter handle, Abimbola Olufunke, or you can send me a text on +234 802-232-42389. Thank you so much for listening to me. I promise you, I'll see you next week. Thank you.
I almost let go. I wouldn't let go.